No, I don't worry. I tell you, I'm a man who believed that I died 20 years ago. And I live like a man who is dead already. I have no fear whatsoever of anybody or anything.
We're gonna take over Fisk.
My brothers,
the administration has to feel it.
Can I get an all power? All power! Can I get an all power to the people?
We need everybody. And we must be prepared for anything.
We need this administration to confront the fact they're not doing enough for Black students on campus, while encouraging them to work with us peacefully.
I've seen DC on fire during the riots. And when have police ever given a fuck about student intentions? Didn't give any during the freedom riots.
But we'll get suspended.
But the pigs, you think we'll get arrested?
We can't be divided in this.
And we won't be. Solidarity isn't an option. It's our only means. But know that if this goes south, it's on all of us. I know we don't see eye to eye on a lot of things. But, are you ready for this takeover? Are you ready? How about y'all? Dwight, Rocky, you two look ready.
You know, that's right, brother.
Today is our day.
Good. Brother Emilio.
Remember why we do this. Today is not just about being denied a day to honor the life of El-Haj Malik Shabazz. Today is about exposing this university's infidelity to its professed goals and questioning the sincerity of its commitment to profound change.
Unfortunately, classes will not be canceled for Malcolm X Day.
Today we make this all-powerful institution work for its Black students as well. Remember why we're up at this ungodly hour and will continue to deprive ourselves of sleep. In just a few hours, we will bring our school's academic process to a halt. And we will do this in the hall named after the famed anti-abolitionist and Wesleyan's first president, Wilbur Fisk, the man who favored the colonization of Blacks in Africa. Remember this and know that you are fighting for something greater than yourselves, greater than this group even. We are fighting for the future of Black history at Wesleyan University.
You will not be able to stay home, brother. You will not be able to plug in, turn on, and cop out. You will not be able to lose yourself on Skag and skip out for beer during commercials because the revolution will not be televised. The revolution will not be televised. The revolution will not be brought to you by Xerox in four parts without commercial interruptions. The revolution will not show you pictures of Nixon blowing a bugle and leading a charge by John Mitchell, General Abrams, and Spiro Agnew to eat hog maws confiscated from a Harlem sanctuary. The revolution will not be televised. The revolution will not be brought to you by the Schaefer Award Theater and will not star Natalie Woods and Steve McQueen or Bullwinkle and Julia. The revolution will not give your mouth sex appeal. The revolution will not get rid of the nub. The revolution will not make you look 5 pounds thinner because the revolution will not be televised, brother. There will be no pictures of you and Willie Mae pushing that shopping cart down the block on the dead run or trying to slide that color TV into a stolen ambulance. NBC will not be able to predict the winner at 8:32 on the court from 29 districts. The revolution will not be televised. There will be no pictures of pigs shooting down brothers on the instant replay. There will be no pictures of pigs shooting down brothers on the instant replay. The revolution will not be televised, will not be televised, will not be televised, will not be televised. The revolution will be no rerun, brothers. The revolution will be live.
We want Black power.
Classes are canceled.
We want Black power. We want Black power. We want Black power. We have stayed here
government. That's all we've been doing, begging, begging. It's time we stand up and take over.
How did we trap ourselves in this building and not even consider that we need something to eat?
Is anyone coming?
No. And obviously, I say this in confidence, but I don't think this is going anywhere. The administration hasn't even come by since 10 a.m.
I'm going to talk about the societal poison. There is our country's obsession with capitalism.
Right on, brother. We're trapped in a vicious cycle of poverty, of ignorance, of apathy, of disease, and of death. And they have these old Uncle Toms, Negro leaders, coming to Harlem, telling you and me that times are getting better. Your times will never get better until you make them better.
My brothers, can I get an all power?
All power!
Can I get an all power to the people?
All power to the people!
Black liberation is liberation for all people. Us white people can never decide when the time is right. We must show solidarity.
Power is defined as the ability to define phenomena and make it act in a desired manner. Black people lack power because we are unable to make the system act in a desired way. Today, we'll show our power.
Right on, brother.
Well, I don't know what will happen now. We've got some difficult days ahead. But it really doesn't matter with me now, because I've been to the mountaintop. I don't mind. Like anybody, I would like to live a long life. Longevity has its place.
Thank God. You made the call?
I know you did.
Hey, that was sisters from Kong College.
No, we have to come support our brothers. Gentlemen, happy to see us.
Thank you, sister.
Mr. Randolph, friends, the women of this country, Mr. Randolph, pledge to you, to Martin Luther King, Roy Wilkins, and all of you fighting for civil liberties, that we will join hands with you as women of this country.
Oh, shit. I think the administrators are coming.
Hey, brother, I think the administrators are here.
Right on, brother. Doors.
They're here.
Glad you gentlemen could make it.
Thank you. Good to see you.
Good to see you, gentlemen. The president has heard your requests and is willing to discuss immediate change in this university.
That's a start.
We have specific demands.
We're here to hear you out.
We demand a black educational program defined by the black students themselves. We demand a black dormitory and cultural center as defined by the black students themselves.
We demand an end to the existing grading system as an evaluation of academic achievement. We demand the right to scrutinize and approve candidates for all administration and faculty positions. We demand that the incoming freshman class be 90% black. We want it understood that the administration will only have 1 week, dating from March 7, to respond in writing to each and all of our demands.